a moment.
Yeah, but they'll do it with tests.
It's not a sticker, it's the case.
It's the case.
What's that?
Isn't that departure?
It's journey. I just got to go. There's a go live, but we're live. Oh, no. That's a good album. But... Yep. Now I see it.
We're journey freaks.
Okay. I saw Journey front row right after Russell was born.
You want to laugh?
Oh, yeah. Aloha. Yeah. Thank you. I think about that. Shabbat shalom, everyone. We're going to get started here in a minute. As you have probably heard, we're kind of dealing with some power outage issues, which is why we're in here. I apologize that it's kind of freezing everywhere. If you need a bathroom, the women's restrooms do have light. For some reason, the men's restrooms don't. Go figure. If you need a restroom, that anyone needs a restroom, but especially for men, use the one in the staff hallway. That one's has got light and power. And see the remark are in the back. And thanks for being with us. You know, we could have canceled services today, but it just didn't feel like the right thing to do. So thank you for being here, those who are here in the room and those who are joining us on live stream. It's it felt important to be able to do services today, especially after the awful attacks in Amsterdam this week. Because this is what we do, we come together as a community in prayer. So Jonathan's going to lead us off this morning. No one will be insulted if you wear your coat if you need it. And Shabbat Shalom. We begin on page 103. We might get rise if you're able to.
Who's in receiver? Who's in receiver?
Peace, and the Shuvah, Ufa, Arbadea, Shimoka, Dato, Ruha, Tanai, the Ufa, Bati, Shavon, Amen. Page 123.
Hallelujah. We rise as we're able to, page 132.
Thank you.
Thank you.
nafshi et Adonai, v'chol mechavai et shem kesho.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh,
We continue on page 158. As we get down towards the bottom of the page, we'll rise as we're able to in preparation for the Amidah, which begins on page 159. We'll begin all together through the Kedusha, and then we'll have some time for personal prayers and reflections. After that, the words in the book are the words in our hearts.
Yeah.
Wow.
continue with our Torah service, page 168. If you're one of those ark openers or Torah carriers, scoot on up.
Shabbat Services. Ulai banem mina vishma avraham kol Amen. Kiyama hagam halom haiti afare roi. Alkin kara lava ber lachai roi. Leben kodesh uben bared. Bate led hagar lavram ben. Bikravram shem beno asher yavla hagar Yishmael. Ve'avram ben shonim shana v'shesh shanim.
We are on the fourth Aliyah, Rav Gate 72, verse number 1.
Mola Khem Mozakar. By the way, while I was gone, Joan and I were not able to do our truth sermon for Simchat Torah, and Eitan and the rabbi did a phenomenal truth sermon. If you haven't seen it, go online to Simchat Torah, the morning service, and watch their truth service on Pathways 1 Hour.
And they spoofed you all because we did not write that.
But is this comment an official endorsement of your message?
I think we should put their vote,
Amen.
Ya'amod, Abraham ben Moshe, Maftir Hazan, you may be seated. Welcome up Albert Baker for the Maftir Aliyah, and Adrian will be reading the Torah for us. We're on page 76, verse 24.
Watch over our armed forces and all those entrusted with our
times of danger, give them courage to act with honor and dignity, as well as insight to do what is right in your eyes. Fill us all with the gifts of love and courage, that we may create a world that reflects your glory. May we each respond to the charge of your prophet. For what does Adonai demand of you, but to act justly, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God? May the one who brings peace on high bring peace and prosperity to our world and keep us in safety. And let us say,
Amen.
I want to personally recognize all the veterans in our community as well today and thank them for their service. We now turn to a prayer for all those in captivity, and before that, a prayer for the Israel Defense Forces. We welcome up Amir Kaufman, and we turn to the back of our seat room.
Shabbat shalom, everyone. It is day 400 of the war. As of today, we have lost 782 IDF soldiers, four of them this week. First Sergeant Itai Parizat, age 20, from Pakhtikwa. First Sergeant Yair Hanania, age 22, from Expanded Tofa. Sergeant Ariel Sosnov, age 20, from Yerushalayim. Master Sergeant Guy Shabtai, age 39, from Yerushalayim. In addition to that, from the beginning of the war, about 50 Israelis committed suicide. The last one was an IDF reservist that served 6 months in Gaza and could not handle, when he came back home, he could not handle what he saw. Many of them, of those people that committed suicide, are Novos Festival survivors. This shows us that even once the war, this war will be over, the scars will be carried for a very long time. The prayer can be found in the back of the Siddurim. We'll do the Hebrew and the English. Please join me to whatever you feel comfortable. Misha Belech Avodei, Abraham Sarah Yaakov, Ve'imoteinu Sarah Rivka Avodei Yaakov, Hu Yevarech Et Chayalei Tzva Avodah Yisrael, Ve'anshe Kofot Ha'Bitachon, Hanilchamim Leman Bitchon Yisrael Shloma. Yiten Lehem Ha'ar Adonai Oz, Ve'Katzev Chushim Neged Oyvenu Hakamim Aleinu, ורוח יתנה, לשמור עליכם ועל צלמה ועל מבחן זו. יגן אדוני עליהם מכל צרה ומצרה, למען ישובו בשלום ובשמחה, אל משפחותיהם ואל חבריהם, ולמען ימשיכו ויפרחו כבני אדם וחווה וכאזרחי מדינתם. May the one who brought blessings to our fathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and to our mothers Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, bless the soldiers of the Israel Defense Forces and all of them in charge to protect the land of Israel. Give them strength against our enemies
and strengthen their spirits to preserve
the highest moral values in this time of trial. Protect them from all troubles and afflictions, so they will return in peace and joy to their families and friends, and may they prosper as human beings and citizens in their land.
Hamas still has 101 people in captivity. The seven names we are calling out this week: Ram Vili, age 24, from Itar; Idan Shtivi, age 28, from Ganetikva; Itai Savritsky, age 38, from Tel Aviv; Tamir Adar, age 38, from Kibbutz Nir Oz; Ilan Weiss, age 56, from Kibbutz Be'er Eri; Judy Weinstein, age 70, from Kibbutz Nir Oz; Sarah Baruch, age 25, from Kibbutz Be'er Eri.
We continue with the words of Achenu, praying for all those Jews held in captivity and also those in anguish at this time in the back of our books.
Amen. Yeah.
belong to. He says, is it possible that the castle lacks an owner? The owner of the building looks out and says, I am the owner of the castle. Similarly, because Abraham Avinu, our father, is it possible that this castle that has no master, no one to look after it, Abraham calls? The Holy One, blessed be God, looked out at Abraham and said to him, I am the master of the universe. And hence, God says to Abraham, Lech Lecha, you go and do the work. We read the paper, we look around in the world, and often we feel like the person traveling, witnessing a palace, a world in flames. There is murder and anger, an anti-Semitic attack in Amsterdam, political vitriol in a divided nation, racism and war. We look out and we see thugs and kidnappers, narcissists trashing the palace. Who is the owner of this palace? Who sits by and does nothing? Where is God? We may feel like we're asking at times. But like Moses' burning bush, the burning world is perhaps a wake-up call. Perhaps like Abraham, we encounter God amidst the destruction, not in spite of it. We ask the owner of the burning castle, where are you? And in turn, He turns to us and asks us, where are you? Lech Lecha, go, do the work. Rabbi Shai Held writes, this biblical motif of suffering and destruction seems to echo a deep truth that many of us know from experience. The deepest blessings we experience often come on the heels of profound and protracted suffering. Take a moment to consider how that lands for you, a difficult truism of life, that we live out our deepest blessings often on the heels of our greatest disappointments in life. In this vein, a congregant who was struggling this week with life circumstances and with the results of the election for her asked me, Rabbi, do you have a prayer for the new president? Well, I have a lot of prayers, but who is he to listen to me? I thought again about Avraham this week, in which God says to Avraham, Lech Lecha, go for you, and I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you, and I will make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. What does it mean to be a blessing for us? Sforno, the 15th century Spanish commentator, says that when it says be hebracha, to be a blessing by God, that is when God rejoices in our actions and our deeds. Sforno cites a beautiful selection of the Talmud from Brachot 7a, in which the context is that Rabbi Yochanan wonders from where it is derived that the Holy One, blessed be God, prays. As it's stated, I will bring them to my holy mountain and make them joyful in the house of my prayer, Beit Tefilati. The verse does not say the house of their prayer, it says the house of my prayer. So that implies that God prays. So naturally, in the way of the Talmud, the Gemara asks, so if God prays, what does God pray? And it answers, Rav Zutra Bar Tovia said that Rav said that God prays, may it be my will that my mercy will overcome my anger and my compassion prevail over my other attributes, and may I conduct myself toward my children with the attribute of compassion, rachami, and may I enter before them, before the letter of the law. And then it goes on to quote a story that illustrates this, in which Rabbi Yishmael ben Elisha, the high priest, on Yom Kippur, once entered the innermost sanctum, the Holy of Holies, to offer incense. And there he had a vision of God, seated upon a high throne. And God said to Yishmael, Yishmael, my son, bless me. And so Yishmael said to God, and similarly, as you saw earlier in the Talmud, may it be your will that your compassion, God, overcome your anger, and may your compassion prevail over all your other attributes, and may you act toward your children with the attribute of compassion, and may you enter before them, before the letter of the law. The Holy One, God, nodded God's head and accepted the blessing of Ishmael. This event teaches us, the Talmud says, that you should not take the blessing of an ordinary person lightly. Jewish tradition imagines din and rachamim, judgment and compassion, as existing in a dynamic tension, as on either side of a tight rope in life, and that we cannot let go in our lives or in the way we serve the world of either end. For a world without judgment leads to anarchy, and a world without compassion leads to tyranny. What do I want to pray for the new president, whether you voted for him or not. What do we want to pray for this new president? Perhaps as Jews, we want to pray for President Trump, and we want to pray for all of us, that his and our compassion overcome our anger, that we all find the ability to balance Dean and Rafamin, our judgment with compassion, that he and we always see that the Jewish people, like in the time of Abraham, are worthy as a light to the nations, something we can't take for granted in today's world, and that we never take the blessing of ordinary citizens lightly. Kenya Hiratzon, may it be God's will. Or in the words of Rabbi Naomi Levy, teach us, God, to treasure the differences that distinguish one person from another. Fill us with the strength to overcome senseless fear and hatred. Open our hearts to the radiance, she writes, that shines forth from other human souls. Inspire us to shed our apathy. Remind us that it is our obligation to be responsible for one another. Open our ears to the cries of those who are in need of our assistance. Give us the courage to combat prejudice and intolerance wherever they exist. Teach us to see each other through your eyes, God, to see one another and see ourselves as a blessing. And bless us, God, with compassion, with kindness, and with peace. Amen.
Amen.
We live in a world in which we are truly divided. As a rabbi, I will never feel like it is my job to tell you who to vote for or how you should act politically. As a person and a human being, my hope for all of us is that we can be the blessing. We can be the one who sees the fire and the world and doesn't just say who put this fire on, but we become the spiritual firefighters to do the work in this world. That's what I want for all of us. That's what I want of any elected official. And that is one of the reasons why I am so truly proud to be a Jewish person. Because in the legacy of Abraham and Sarah, and the legacy of so many people in our tradition, we are not afraid to find the bucket, to make the hose, and do the work of making this world that sometimes truly feels ignited in different ways, of putting out the fire, of dampening the smoke, of making Shabbat services happen even when there's no light or power or heat, but to come together and look one another in the face, to come together whether you voted for Trump or Harris, to come together and do the holy work of building the next chapter in our community, in our country, in our world together. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
We'll now continue with our Musaf service. We invite up Eitan Cantor, page 184.
He's bored, he doesn't even hear us.
I'm not going to do all the Musaf to the tune of Come Together.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
I just wanted to shout out a voice track to Musaf to my friend Jay Englander, who's here in St. Louis, with my cousins, and he's someone I always looked up to, I still look up to. You can sing any service from the whole year, and he knows the Musaf, and not just like a little bit, but he can like really go deep in it and get fascinated by it, which I was been impressed by. He's an amazing leader, and so just excited to have you here. And be careful, because next time you're here, you're definitely going to make it out.
Today I just get to sit back in the bell.
Yeah, exactly.
I also wanted to just celebrate the value of rest. I took a few days off this week, went to Los Angeles, and hung out in Joshua Tree National Park. And if you haven't taken a little bit of rest, please, I invite you to find a way to take some rest. If you need support in doing that, maybe somebody here can help you get the support. And a little melody came into my mind, which hasn't happened for a while because I had a little bit of rest. So, you'll hear that in the meeting after the second meeting, and then we'll use it for who else we need. I think we're going to record it with Yoni Gopi, who is the son of Gopi and Peter Gopi. Yoni's in Los Angeles studying to be a producer, and he's going to put some hip hop beat to it, and we're going to add like, some horns. So, yeah, take some rest, maybe something new will come into your room. You realize I'm just waiting for it.
I am the
185. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu v'Elohe avoteinu v'Elohe Avraham v'Elohe Yitzchak v'Elohe Yaakov v'Elohe Sarah v'Elohe Rivka v'Elohe Rachel v'Elohe Leah El Hagadol Hagibol v'Hanora El Elyon Gomer Chasadim Etzavim V'Koneh Hakol V'Tochech Hazer Yavod. You may be proud of me, I am a man. Mechalkel chayim v'chesed, mechayim v'itim v'rachamim rabim. Somech nofzim v'rofech olim, u'matir asurim, u'mevlayen eunato, ishene yachar, mi'chamo. Baruch atah Adonai, mechayei ha-metim,
Oh, my God.
לכל החיים ידוך הסלה, וילדו שלך ואמרתי נשואתנו, ועזרתנו סלה, ברוך אתה אדוני, על כל שמך לפניו להודות. נותנו לאוצרנו וברכנו בברכה משולשת, בתורת וידי משה עבדך, אמורה מפי הלבנה, כהנים עם קדושך כאמור. יברכך אדוני וישמרך, אדוני פניו אליך ויחונך, אדוני פניו אליך וישם לך שלום. שים שלום טובה וברכה, חן וחסד רחמים ורחמים עלינו ועל כל ישראל.
Sunday, November 10th at 10 a.m., join Rabbi Shulman for a book review and baked goods on the book of Noah Tishbi and Emmanuel Akom, Uncomfortable Conversations with a Jew. This is a timely, disarmingly honest, and thought-provoking investigation into anti-Semitism that connects the dots between the tropes and the hatred of the past to our current complicated moments. That was a hard one for me to read. On Monday, November 11th, we will be continuing Rabbi Mordechai Magenzi, a class about the four religions. This class this week is Buddhism. Buddhism. Please sign up on our website. He is a fabulous teacher. On Thursday, November 13th at 6:30 p.m. Oh, Monday is at 6?
6:30.
6:30 on Monday. Thank you.
Amir, if Monday is the 11th, then Wednesday is the
13th. All right.
Be all
no,
they're
fine.
I'm confused which day this activity is.
This coming Monday.
No, the other one. The
Thursday. It says Thursday, November 13th. So
yeah,
the screening of the movie is Thursday or Wednesday?
Come both days.
Exactly.
Check
the website. How about that? Thank you, Rabbi. Check the website for the HBO special just for us, either Wednesday or Thursday. We'll keep you on the edge here. We want to make sure that this show won an Emmy an attorney, and it's a true story, on one comics visit to a nationalist meeting. Afterwards, joined Sue Parker Gerson for a discussion on the show. Azamra joined us next Friday. I will not say the date. And Tot Shabbat the following Shabbat, the day after. Saturday, yes. November 17, from 3:30 to 5 p.m., Babi Zedi and me will return with an event to make a scrapbook with your grandchildren, best suited for kids 4 plus, mentally and physically. November 19 at 7 p.m., we'll be hosting an event for the American Friends of Ben-Gurion, Frontline Conversations, Resilience Amidst Tragedy, with special guests Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Elbo Arama, PhD, who risked everything to save lives during the Hamas attack at the Nova Festival, Music Festival. The movie series continue with Woman's Balcony, and yes, we have changed the movie originally. I think the Woman's Balcony is a much better choice, and this will take place on Thursday, November 21st at 6:30 p.m. In the shul. Sign up online. Thank you, everyone. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Thank you, Amir. We'll continue with Ein Kelohenu, page 204.
Just one more upcoming event. Rosh Hashanah is next year. I'm not going to say the date, but it's sometime near the beginning of Tishrei.
Ein Kelohenu, Ein Kelohenu, Ein Kelohenu, Ein Kemoshienu, Mikelohenu, 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 No de la Dodeno, no de la Makeno, no de la Moshienu, Baruch Eloheinu, Baruch Adonainu, Baruch Eloheinu, Baruch Moshienu, Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Makeno, Atahu Moshienu, Atahu Zetiru, Baruch Eloheinu, Lefanecha,
as we're able to for Aleinu, page 204.
כתוב את הורתך אדוני נוח לעולם נברד
to page 207 for Mourner's Cottage. We send our condolences to Ken and Shelley Lazier, as well as to Arlene Aaron and Carrie Friedman on their recent losses. Our community sends love and support to you and your families. Mourner's Cottage, page 207. Yidkadal v'yidkadash shemei rabba.
Amen.
V'yama divra firute v'yamlich malchute. Bechayechon, uvyomechon, uvchaye dechol beit Yisrael, bagala uvizman kariv vimru,
amen.
Yehei shnei rabba mivorach leolam omei omaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yipa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase. Yitadar v'yitalev v'yitalal shmei dikudsha
v'yitru.
La'ela min kol birchata v'shirata Tush bavata v'nechemata. Dami run b'yama v'imru. Amen. Yehe shalom rabba min shemaya. V'chaim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael. V'imru. Amen. Ose shalom v'imromav. Hu yaseh shalom. Aleinu v'al kol Yisrael. V'imru. Amen. I'd like to welcome up any kids in the house. Are there any other kids back there? I think Rami might still be. Rami, are you in the house? Aviva's here. Saw some other that come. Emily. Yeah, here we go. Come on in, kiddos. Come on up front. We're going to do some kiddush. I invite everyone to stand physically or spiritually. Cool shades, Aviva. My future is so bright, I gotta wear these sunglasses. All right, Rami, you ready? All right, Rami is the first access to the grape juice today, right? All right, you might need to get rid of one of those trains, though, so you can hold it. All right, kids, can you come in front? There you go. Okay, ready? On the count of three. Chad, Shtayim, Shalosh.
Ruth HaGadon, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Borei Bri HaKaven.
Go for it.
You can have a special white shirt for this.
Oh, good job. Okay, here we go. Will you be our hand washer today?
Beautiful job. Great story for lollipop.
Yeah.
And now there's color.
All right, here we go. Ready? Yeah, push up the sleeves. There we go. There we go. Hands in the bowl. Oh, there we go. Put your hands in the bowl. Yeah, there you go. Other hand, too. Perfect. All right. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher kishanu b'mitzvotah v'tzivanu al mitzvot yadayim. All right, here we go. Okay, Rami, you're not interested in challah, are you? Come back over here. The cutest,
yes, I am.
The cutest hamotzi ever was at Rami's sister's brief bat, her baby naming. There was this huge challah, and he and his cousin were holding either end of it. And then it was like a moment of, what's that movie?
Lady and the
Tramp. Yeah.
Oh, really?
When they just started eating it afterwards. Okay, you want to hold one? All right, do you guys want to hold one over here? Ready? What, don't eat it yet. Hold on. You guys see the blessing first. I know, it's kind of a cool trick we play.
Hamotzi lechem min haaretz. We give thanks to God for bread. Our voices rise in song together as our joyful prayer is said. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
And I'll take a big bite. All right, you guys want to rip that up? There you go, Emily. You can share. All right, let's conclude with Adon Olam, and then we invite you to bring your coat and your friends and head to Kiddush lunch outside. Not really outside.
Adon Olam Asher Malach Beterem Kol Yisir Nivra Le'et Asar Echef Sokol Azai. Levado imloch nora
Yeah.